My grandma is starting to get rid of some of her things, though. She's starting to divide it up. When I was home last Christmas, she was kind of starting to give things to my aunts and me, and she was like, you know, when I die, I want to give you my doll collection. And I was like, no thanks. My life is haunted enough. Thank you so much. What the fuck am I going to do with the doll collection? Like, please give me anything else. Give me your slippers. Give me your walker. Give me the 10,000 plastic bags you've been saving under your sink for some reason. What special occasion is that for? What emergency? Killing 9,000 dolphins? I don't understand. It's like, I don't even know if my grandma's aging so much as she is transferring her energy into the dolls. You know, like, if you look at... Like, if you see my grandma, her hair is thinning, her eyes are turning gray. You look at the dolls, their hair is thinning, their eyes are turning gray. What's happening there, you guys? And she has them all locked in a case that's also locked in a room. I'm like, why are they behind double locks? No one's trying to get in, you know? That means something's trying to get out. Do you understand what I'm saying here? What's happening? Plus, I live in a studio apartment, you know? Like, what am I going to do with a bunch of dolls? Just, like, line them up? Some guy comes over, I'm like, welcome. Please take your shoes off and don't make eye contact with my friends. I mean the dolls. It's not even a gift you can politely take and then throw away later because I feel like they'll just climb out of the trash, you know, in the middle of the night and choke me to death. That's how I imagine that happening. I might take just one, though. As a warning, you know, just one and put it up on the shelf. And when a guy comes over, I'll be like, well, that's what happened to the last guy that didn't make me come. So, like, your call. He's in there. My grandma has dementia, which is sad. You know, it's sad to see her go. But she's happy as shit, which is nice. Yeah, I think it's because she finally realized, or, like, she doesn't realize she's related to us, you know? She just sees us and she's like, who are these fucked up strangers? It's your family. It is interesting though, because like my whole life, anytime I've talked to her, we've had the same boring conversation over and over again. Like I love her so much, but we just talk about the weather and the news and like, you know, like barely even the news and our family. Now I call her and I'm like, hey, what's going on, Grandma? And she's like, I just talked to the devil. And I'm like, amazing. What's going on with the devil? My aunts hate it. They're like, don't ask her about the devil. I'm like, no, I want to hear about the devil, okay? She's like, he came into the house and he clipped my nails. I'm like, amazing. Does he do pedicures too? Can I get a referral? What's going on with the devil? Keep me updated on that. Here's the thing, my grandma's very Catholic, which means either the devil is real, or this is the best prank of all time, you know? She's just on her way out and she's dead serious, like, devil's real, guys, bye, you know? We're like, have you talked to God? She's like, no, just the devil, I'm out.